Hi everyone, this is Kanna Babu. Welcome to Java Musings. Today we'll discuss about scanner class in Java. So generally in application development, we already know when you write a Java program, this data, you must know about data. Data is basically divided into two types. One is static data, other one is dynamic data. Static data means at the development time, if the developer will fix any values, the type of data is called as static data. So generally if I write one program like this, public static void main, and here if I try to write string args, okay, and here bracket open, bracket close, and here if I declare one variable, string f name is equal to Satya, and here I will try to give string l name is equal to technologies, here I will try to give string l name is equal to technologies, okay. And here I want to display the full name. So here I will write string full name is equal to f name plus l name. And I want to print the output. SOPLN statement I will write system.out.println. println. Here I will try to print. I want to print the full name. Okay. So here if you observe clearly, this program is a static program. Static program means how many times you run the program, you will get the same output. Because the input is fixed. If the input is fixed, output is also fixed. But generally in real time in the application development, end user will not give any input. If you want to run this program, you can see. I will try to run this program. So I'll try to open one notepad and I'll try to copy this program. Okay. Here I'll try to paste it. Save the program as a.java. And here I'll try to compile the program. Open your command prompt. Here I'll try to compile the program. Java C space A dot Java. Execute the program. Got some error is there. So here println spelling is wrong. Yes, now you can save the program. Just to check here, compile the program. Java C space A dot Java. Compiled successfully. Execute the program. Java space A. Enter. Again you execute the program. Again you execute the program. How many times you'll execute the program? You'll get the same output. Are you following? So, but in application development in real time, the end user will give the input. End user will give the input. For example, if I write something like enter first name, and here if I try to write something like enter last name, and here I have one button, something like display. Now, generally this type of forms, if you want to design, you can design by using HTML. Here you can see. But if you want to save this data in the database, you have to write the Java code. So generally, who will give the input means end user will give the input. Who will interact with this form? End user. For example, here I will try to give my name Kanna as first name, Babu as last name. And click on button. Now I want to display the output as Kanna Babu or Anil and Kumar. The input will change, the output will change. So definitely, in the application development, dynamic program will be there. So in that scenario, developer must read the input from console. So how to read the runtime values? So in Java, in order to read the runtime values, you must take the support of scanner class. Okay, generally we already know about system.out.println. So what is system.out.println here? You can see, if you want to print the statement, you have to use system.out.println. SOPLN statement is there. So system.out.println, it is used to write a line on console window and place the cursor in the next line. Here if I print two messages, welcome to Satya Technologies, learn Java by Kanna Babu. Now these two, first the first statement will print and it will place the cursor in the next line, the second statement will print. Similarly, system.out.print, it is used to write a line on console window and place the cursor on the same line. Then you have to use system.out.print. So what is the use of scanner class in Java? Scanner is a predefined class that is available under java.util package. So the main purpose of scanner class is used to read the input values at runtime. So if you want to read the input values at runtime, you can use this scanner. But one point is there that if you want, by default, at runtime values will consider the value in the form of string. Generally in application development, you can see different forms are there. For example, I have a requirement like enter student number, enter student name. Otherwise, I'll give some simple example, enter first number, enter second number, and here I'll try to take one button called add button, some sub button, and here the end user will enter this first number and second number in the text boxes. is it clear? These are the two buttons. Now whenever the, now for example, if the end user will enter the first number as 12, second number as 10 and click on this add button, what I am expecting the answer is 12 plus 10 answer will be what? Some 22. But actually in real time in the application development, whatever the value that you enter, by default this value will consider in the form of string. So we cannot perform arithmetic operations on strings. So the answer will be 12 plus 10, answer will be 1210. So that is the problem. So as a developer, what you have to do? You have to do typecasting, converting one data type value to another data type. So whatever the input the end user is given in the text box, by default that input is considered as string. So how to convert string to integer, some typecasting, auto boxing, unboxing, some techniques are there. But here, if you want to read only integer value from console, or if you want to read a float value from console, you have some ready-made methods that are available provided under scanner class. Scanner is a predefined class available under java.util package. So if you want to read a integer value, you can use nextint method. If you want to read a string value, you can use next method or next line method. But JDK some versions will not support next line methods. You can use next method. Is it clear? It will use to read the input value from the string. So what are the steps to work with this scanner class? Let us see. I will do a small program with scanner class. So here I will try to declare one class. Some name of the class I will give as a demo. And here I will write something like, I will try to declare one package, something like import java.util.scanner. You can use import java.util.star or import java.util.scanner. Are you following everyone? Now here you can see. Here you can see. Here I will try to declare one main method. Something like this public. I'll declare the main method. Public static void main. And here you can write something like string args. String args. And here what I want to do means I want to create an object for scanner class. Scanner is a predefined class. You can create an object. Scanner sc is equal to new scanner of. New scanner of, here you can give system.in. Means you are reading the input from the console. Are you following? And I want to print one statement, you can print. System.out.println. System.out.println of, I want to enter some name. Something like here I will try to give enter first name. Enter first name. I want to store that number, name in my variable. So here I will try to take one variable. String fname is equal to, here I will try to write something like sc dot next of, it will read the string value. That string value I am storing in one variable. And similarly here I will try to give something like enter what last name. You can use next line also, but some JDK is not supporting next line, means use next of. And here you can take another variable and store the value, sc dot next of. So what is the meaning of this? Means we are reading the input values from the console. It's very very important. And here I want to find the full name. String full name is equal to, here I will try to give f name plus l name, and I want to print the output. I want to print the output system.out.println of, I want to display the full name. So how to display the full name? Here you can give full name. Okay, so this is my reading runtime values. Now this is my command prompt. Is it clear? This is my command prompt. When you execute the program, line by line the program will get executed. So line number 1 will execute here. Here it will ask, it will print the statement. So here it will print the statement, enter first name. Now the end user will press enter and he will give the first name. I will give some first name and I want to read this first name and store in this variable. So sc.next method, what it will do, it will read the string value. Now it is stored in this fname variable. And again the next line will execute, it will print. Enter last name. Enter last name. And press enter, here you can enter the last name. Now this sc.next method will read this input Babu and store in this lname variable. Now Kanna plus Babu, Kanna Babu, it will print the output. Let us save this program and once let us test this program. Here I will try to go to save as, I will try to save the program as demo.java. Press save. Now here I will try to compile the program. How to compile the Java program? Java C space file name dot java. Press enter. Fine. Execute the program java space demo. Now asking the user to enter the first name. We are asking the user to enter the first name. I will enter Satya and here I'll enter technologies. This is a dynamic program. Again I will execute. Now I'll enter my name, Kanna and Babu, and again I will try to execute. And here I'll try to give something like Sumit, and here I'll try to give Bajaj, Sumit Bajaj. So if your input will change, output also will change. Some Jaydeep, and here I'll try to give Babu, something like that. So this is called a dynamic program. So if you want to read the input from the console, you can use this next off method. Sir, I want to read an integer value, what to do? Here you see, for example, enter first number. I want to store the first number in one variable, x. So here you can use next int method. Next int method. Sir, no, to read the integer value. Are you following? And store the value in one variable. Which variable? Integer variable. If you want to read an integer value, you have to store in integer variable. And similarly, here you can take enter second number. So don't use next of method. Next of method will always read the value in the form of what? String. So if you want to read the value in the form of integer, you have separate method is there. Next int method is there. Similarly, int sum is equal to x plus y. And here you can print the output system dot out dot println. Now if I want to print the sum. Is it clear? Or you want to get the output like this, sum is. Something like this, sum is plus sum. This is very, very important, scanner. Again, you save the program. Again, you compile the program. Again, clear the screen, CLS. Compile the program, Java C space demo dot Java. Execute the program, Java space demo. Now, ask me to enter the first number, 12. Second number, 10. Sum is 22. Again, execute. First number, 20. Second number, 10. Sum is 30. So, dynamic input, dynamic output will come. So, how to read the values from console in Java means by using scanner class. I hope you enjoyed this video. Please subscribe this channel. Try to share, like. Thank you. Catch you later in the next video.